Today, inshallah, we are going to finish 3.7 that we have started in the previous class, ya Shabab. So we will do a quick review for what we did yesterday in the previous class, and then we will continue 3.9. We will go to section 3.9, inshallah. So first of all, you should remember, ya Shabab, that this section 3.7 is about the rates of change in the natural and social sciences. But we will not focus on that according to the syllabus. We will just study example number one, which will be about the rates of change in physics, especially in the linear motion, when we have velocity, acceleration, displacement, and so on. So I think you know from the previous class what we mean by the linear motion, the position or the displacement function. And how to find also the distance traveled, the velocity, acceleration. Today we will focus more on when the particle or an object or whatever moving forward in the positive direction or moving backward in the negative direction. And also when a particle is speeding up or slowing down. So it is just one example, Shabab. But of course, we will study everything here mentioned in this example. So what is the distance? It is better to say here the distance. I will change it. I think it is here we are talking about the distance. When you have time T1 to time T2, and you want to find the distance traveled during this period of time, then it will be the absolute value of the position function at T2 minus the position function at T1. Oh, it is always positive, the distance, ya Shabab, because this is why we use the absolute value. The velocity, you know, it is the rate of change of displacement. So it will be taman with respect to time. So this is why we differentiate with respect to t. And also the acceleration, which will be the instantaneous rate of change of the velocity with respect to time also. So it is the second derivative of the position function, or it is the first derivative of the of the velocity function. A particle will be at rest when its velocity is zero. And it will move forward in the positive direction when the velocity is positive. When the velocity is negative, it will move backward. And this means the negative direction. It speeds up when it is pushed into the same direction it moves. So what does that mean mathematically? It speeds up when the velocity is positive and increasing, or negative and decreasing. So also to make it much easier, this means that the velocity and the acceleration are positive. This is the velocity is positive, this is done. When the velocity is increasing, you know that the acceleration is the derivative. So the derivative will be positive. So this means that V is positive and A is positive. Or V is negative in this case, or V is negative and A is negative. So when they have the both, they have the same sign, then it will be speeding up. And of course, consequently, it will slow down if they have opposite sign. So I summarize that here for you. So it will speed up when the velocity is and the acceleration have the same sign. And when they have opposite signs, it will slow down. It will slow down in a Shabab when? It will slow down when the velocity is positive and decreasing. Oh, I forgot to record. No, it is recorded. Good. I have recorded this with the previous class, no problem. So it will slow down when it is positive but decreasing, or negative and increasing. So it will slow down. We will see that with the following example. Here we have a polynomial function that represents the position of a particle at specific time t. In general here, t is a variable, of course. Now, we have started this example in the previous class. We need to find the velocity at time t. Is the sound, ya Shabab, is okay? Because I have noticed yesterday
yes.
that there
yes.
were some problems with the sound. Sometimes it goes high and high, or sometimes it will slow down and it will disappear sometimes. It disappears. So please let me know if there is any problem in the sound. And also I want you to forgive me because the tone of my voice is usually high. And this is my nature. I cannot do nothing about it. بعض الطلاب بيقول لي يعني كأنك بتهاوش يعني ما يعني، لكن هذه طبيعة الصوت، عندي الصوت مرتفع شوي. أتذكر لما كنا بندرس كان بيسمعون الطلاب للنكست روم in the classes. Anyway يا شباب، find the velocity at time t. So in general, find the velocity. You know, just find the derivative of this function. طبعا here it is s equals to f of t, t cubed minus t squared plus 90. This is the derivative. Polynomials, so easy to be differentiated. Now, what is the velocity after 2 seconds? The velocity is after 2 seconds, you will just bot t equals to 2, and then bot t equals to 4. So this will give you the velocity after 2 seconds and the velocity after 4 seconds. Look, here the velocity is negative, which means, of course, that the particle is moving in the negative direction. This means that it is moving in the positive direction. When is the particle at rest? The particle will be at rest, as we agreed, Shabab, when the velocity is what?
Zero.
So now you will put this equal to zero. And you have now a quadratic equation, solve it. How to solve quadratic equation? Factor, take three as a common factor, then factor this out as a trinomial. Then you will have t equals 1 and t equals to 3. This means that the particle will be at rest after 1 second and then after 3 seconds. So it will change the direction. This means that it is going to change the direction. Why it becomes at rest? Because it will go to this at this time, and after that it will change the direction, as we will see in the next slides. When is the particle moving forward, which means in the positive direction? When the velocity is what? When the velocity is positive, it is strictly positive. You cannot say greater than or equal. No, it is strictly greater than. So now you will put the velocity equal in inequality. You have an inequality. This is greater than zero. Solve this inequality. How to solve an inequality, ya shabab? Do you remember? Factor it like what you do for equations. Now you need to make a table of values, or you can make a table. Usually you prefer to use table, Shabab. This is 1, this is 3, or let me write it here. This is 1, this is 3. Usually you will write here t minus 1, here t minus 3. And at the bottom line, you will write the product of them. And of course, you will say, this is t minus 1. After 1, this is open. After 1, it will be positive. And before 1, it will be negative. After 3, it will be positive, and before 3, it will be negative, because here we have positive t. Now here it will be positive times positive, positive, positive times negative is negative, negative times negative is positive. This is what you use to do in math 001. Now here it is positive. This is the velocity, by the way. The velocity here is positive, so it will move in the positive direction from, what is this? What is the beginning here? When we say t less than 1, it doesn't mean that it will go to negative infinity, no. The time, Shabab, usually starts from zero, and it should be mentioned here in the problem itself. Look, where t is measured in seconds. So they should, in many problems, they mention it is here. In many problems, they will mention that t is greater than or equal to zero, or sometimes even greater than zero. You cannot have zero. So t is positive here. So we will start from zero. So from 0 to 1, during the first 1 second, it will move in the positive direction. It will be, it moves forward. From the from time number 1 second to 3 seconds, it will move backward in the negative direction. After that, it will move in the forward, in the positive direction, forward. Is that clear, Shabab? So by default, if you know where it is positive, it will be negative otherwise. So here where it is positive, and here it will be negative direction. Draw a diagram. This will explain more. Draw a diagram to represent the motion of the particle. Now, to draw a diagram, what you are going to do, you will draw a horizontal line. This is the position function, Shabab. So here, this is the start point. When the time is zero, s is zero. What is s? S is the position function. This is s. So when t is zero, s is zero. Now it will move, we said that it will move in the positive direction until 1. So the positive direction, Shabab, in our case, it is the right direction. When we go right, this is the positive direction. So now at time t1, t equals one, what will be the position function? If you put here in the function f of t equals t cubed, I think minus t t squared plus 12t. If you put here t equals to one, you will have four. T s will be four here. This is s. And now it will change the direction. It will go backward in the negative direction. The negative direction here, it is the left, when it is goes to the left in our case. Now until what? Until three, until t equals to three. And when you put t equals to three here, you will get zero. S will be zero because it will go back to its original place, look. And after that, it will move forward forever.
After so it's 90, not 12, I think.
Sorry?
It's 90, not 12t.
I think so, yes. I'm not sure. Just it is 6. And this is 9, not 12. You mean this one, yes. This is 9t and this is 60. Excellent. Any question, Shabab, so far? Now, let's go to the next part. Find the total distance traveled by the particle during the first 5 seconds. This is a very important question. I have noticed that many old exams questions are talking about or asking about the total distance traveled. I have mentioned the total distance traveled in the introduction. So now we need to calculate the distance traveled from t equals one until t equals what? Until t equals five. So the period of time here that we have, it is one and zero. Zero and five. The first 5 seconds. So this is the 5 seconds that we have. Now, if you go back to the chart, if the particle is moving this direction only until five, let's say this is five. This is five, for example. I can draw it here. This is zero. This is t equals to zero and until t equals to five. If the particle is moving in one direction, this is so easy. It will be just f at 5 minus f at 0. Well, as hell. If it is going in the same direction, it is so easy. And to make sure that it is positive, you can, of course, take the absolute value. But what is the problem here that our particle, it moves and it changes. It changed the directions. So it moves forward in this until 1. After 1, it will move backward. And after that, it will move backward forward again. So we need now to calculate the distance traveled from here to here, then from here to here, and then from here to there. So we need to calculate the distance traveled over how many intervals, Yashaba?
Three.
Over three intervals. Let's remember together, we said that it will move from zero to one, and then it will change, then until three and until five. This is five. So now here it will be positive direction, negative direction, positive direction. This is the velocity. Now here, this is zero. So what we need to do here to calculate the distance, we will calculate the distance traveled from five to three during this period of time. And we will add also, this is absolute value to make sure that it is positive. And here the absolute value of from three to one. And then we will add from one to zero, from zero to one indeed, but we calculated this one. So this is the idea that you need here because what we have from before, we need to calculate the total distance traveled over these three intervals separately and then sum them up and then add them. So this is the function, the position function. So you need to calculate it during the first second. Then from the second, from one to three, f at three minus f at one, and then f at five minus f at three. I usually prefer to start with this one, Shabab. عشان ما تنسى, شوف. Start with f at five minus f at three, then f at three minus f at one, then f at one minus f at zero. Now what you will do to find the total, this is the meaning of the total. This is distance traveled. This is the total distance traveled. The total distance traveled will be the sum of them. So it will be 28. So look what will happen, Shabab. If someone asks why we didn't calculate it just f at five minus f at zero, What will happen if we did it like this? It will be 20 log. It will be f at five, it is 20 minus f at zero. What is f at zero? F at zero, it is zero. So it will be 20. So it will be less than the total distance traveled.
So because this is the
calculated here.
This is the displacement, right?
Yes, it is the displacement function. We mentioned that at the beginning. This is the displacement function.
No, I mean, if he asked about this displacement, we take 5 minus 0 only, right?
The displacement could be negative, but the total distance traveled should be positive. You know that? It depends on the direction, Taban. In the displacement, there is a direction. But when we talk about the distance is always positive.
Okay.
Excellent, ya shabab. Any question, please? So how to calculate the total distance traveled? You need to calculate it over the intervals that the velocity will be positive and negative. You need to consider this part. You should know where the function is moving forward or when it is moving backward. If it is moving always forward, it will be very easy, or always backward. It will be very easy. Just calculate it from the beginning until the end. But when it changes its behavior, you need to consider that. Find the acceleration at t and at 4. So easy. The acceleration is the derivative of the velocity. So differentiate the velocity or differentiate the position twice, the position function. So this is what you are going to have if you differentiate this. It will be 6t, the derivative of t, minus 12. This is the acceleration at any time t. Now, after 4 seconds, it means that you will put t equals to 4. And this will give you 12 minutes per second squared. And this is the unit of the acceleration, of course. Now, graph the position, velocity, and acceleration functions for t between 0 and 5. So how to sketch the graph of them, Shabab? You have them. Here they are. And you can start with the acceleration. The acceleration is very easy function. It is just a line. Do you want me to do that? Let me do it here, just a sketch. So when t is 2, it will be 0. So this is 2. And it will be increasing, Taban, because the slope is positive. So it will be something like this. But we will not focus just from 0. We will draw from 0 to where? To 5. This is 5. So it will be something like this. This is the acceleration. So easy. Now, what about this? How to draw this? This one, Shabab, is a parabola. Do you remember? We have factored. Do you remember? Take 3 as a common factor, and it will be t minus 1, t minus 3. We did factor it before. Revise what we did before. So now this means that it will be 0 at 1 and 3. So it has 2 x-intercepts at 1 and at 3. Now, when this is a Shabab polynomial, the leading coefficient is positive. So it will be up. Do you remember that? Because it is of degree 2. So here it will be up. Here it will be down. And until 1, it will go up again. So this is the velocity function. Now, how to draw this function? It is not difficult also. Take t as a common factor. You will have t squared minus 6t plus 9. What is this? This is just t minus 3 all to the power 2. Am I right? Perfect square. This is of degree 3, and it is positive. The leading coefficient is positive. So it will open up to the right, down to what? Down to the left. Do you remember that? So here it will be up. It has 2 x-intercepts at 0 and at 3. So here it will be up. Let's say it will, I don't know how it looks like, but let's say it is something like this. It will be here squared. It will touch, no intersection. It will not cross. So it will be like this. And it will go up to 0. And we will stop at 0. Don't continue. It will go this way. But we are not interested in that behavior. So this is the velocity. This is the the position or the displacement function. I think we have it better than. The graph here is much better. And don't worry, they will not ask you to sketch the graphs in this case. But this is just for you to understand. But you should be able to do that if you are asked to do. So the blue one is the velocity here. The red is the position function and the green is the acceleration. Is that clear? Now let's go to the next part. When is the particle speeding up and when it is slowing down? You should remember that it speeds up when the velocity and the acceleration have the same sign, and when they have opposite, it will slow down. Now, this means that you need to know where this is positive, where it is negative. We know that from before. Do you remember? Here it is. We did it for the velocity. Now, for the acceleration, we need to know also for the acceleration where it is positive, where it is negative. So this is the acceleration. It is 6t minus 12. Take 6 as a common factor. Now you need to put this equals to 0. And after that, what is the 0 of it? It is 2. It will be 0 at 2. Now, after 2, it will be positive. Before 2, it is negative. Is that clear? So the acceleration will be positive after 2. I think we should draw it here. So let me mention this over 1. So if after 2, it will be positive. After 2, it will be negative. Now, we need to know where both of them are positive or where both of them are negative, where they have the opposite signs. We should combine these two charts. By the way, these are not in your book, Ashraf. I have created them by myself to you. So now we need to combine them together. So what will happen? Let me draw a line like this. So this is zero. The beginning is zero. The starting is zero. One. Let me draw it like this. This is one. This is two. This is three. It is enough. Now, from 0 to 1, what about the velocity here, Shabab? The velocity is what from 0 to 1? It is positive. Let me draw it here. The above 1 is the velocity. Now, what about the acceleration from 0 to 1? This is 1. This is 3. What it will be?
Negative.
It will be negative. Now, from 1 to 2, this is 2. From 1 to 2, the velocity is what?
Negative.
And the acceleration?
Negative.
Negative also. Log from 1 to 2 is negative. Now from 2 to 3, the velocity from 2 to 3 is negative.
Negative.
And the velocity, the acceleration is positive. Positive. After 3, both are positive. Now both are positive. Now we can know where they are, when they are slowing down and speeding up. Here, what do you think, Yashabab?
Slowing down.
Slowing down, and they have different opposite signs. Here, so they will
speeding up.
Speed up, and here's slow down. So we will just write up and down. Here, down.
Down.
Here, up.
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 Uh-huh. So it is clear now, ya shabab. I did that for you here. It is combined. It is already there. Now, you can know that, ya shabab, by the way, from the graph. Not only like this. This is a good way to know if you don't have the graph. But if you have the graph, you can know it from the graph much. It will be much easier to know it from the graph. Let me explain for you how to represent this now. Also, I did this for you. Look here, from 0 to 1, it's slowed down. From 1 to 2, speeding up. From 1 to 3, slow down. From 3 and up to 5, for example, it speeds up. Now here, because the velocity here is positive, it moves forward. Here it is negative, it will move backward. The velocity here is positive, it moves forward. As I said, you can know that from the graph, Shabab. How can I know that from the graph? I need to know where it is, مثلاً, speeding up. لا خلينا أبدأ بالباك بال forward وbackward. كيف تعرف إن هي moves backward or forward؟ طبعا forward it means that the velocity is positive. هذه معناها ان the velocity negative. صح؟ لاحظ معاي فين الجراف حقت the velocity؟ هذا هو يا شباب ال blue one. Now you know يا شباب this is the x-axis. Above the x-axis greater than zero. Y is greater than zero. Below the x-axis y is less than zero. So our x-axis is this, the t. So here we have t, and this will be the velocity in our case. This is the velocity function. So لما تكون the velocity positive, لاحظوا معي يا شباب, above the x-axis, the graph of the velocity is above the x-axis. So it is what? Positive. The v هنا positive. So it is what? Moving forward from 0 to 1. At 1, it has x-intercept. At 1, it will be at rest. Now, from 1 to, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. From 1 to 2, from 1 to 2, and up to 3, it is below the x-axis, am I right?
Yes.
So it will slow down, sorry, it will move in the negative direction, backward. And after 3, it is positive, it is above the x-axis, it will move back, forward. So you can know from the graph of the velocity where it is positive, where it is negative, where it is moving backward or forward. Is this clear? Because sometimes they can give you just the graph. You have exercises in your book about this. Okay, now let's move to the second part. How to know where it is speeding up or slowing down? Look, from 0 to 1, look at the graph of the velocity. The velocity is what? Positive and what? Decreasing.
Slow down.
So it will slow down. Look. Here, from 0 to 2, from one to two, it is negative and what?
Decreasing.
So it will speed up. Positive and increasing, negative and decreasing, this is speeding up. If it is positive and decreasing, negative and increasing, it will slow down. Look here, it is negative but increasing from 2 to 3. So it will slow down from 2 to 3. And from 3 up, look at the acceleration. It is positive and increasing, it will speed up. But it is not, if it is not clear for you like this, you can just compare what? The graph of the velocity and the graph of the acceleration, as we did. We said, if they have the same sign, then it speeds up. When they have opposite signs, it slows down. So look at this. From 0 to 1, from here to here. The velocity is positive. And the acceleration?
Negative.
Negative, because this is above the x-axis, this is below the x-axis. So here it is positive, the velocity positive, the acceleration. Let me say just V and A. V is positive, A is negative, so slowing down. From 1 to 2.
Negative.
V is positive, A is negative, opposite signs. V is positive, what is V? V is negative, sorry. V is negative below the x-axis, and also it is below the x-axis. Both of them are negative, so it's speeding up. Here, from here to here, it will speed up. Now, from 2 to 3, the V is negative, but A is positive, so it will slow down. Now, from 3 up to 5, up to the end, this is 4, I think. This is 4 and whatever, 5, let's call it 5. From 3 to 5, the end of the interval time, the V is positive and A is positive. Both of them are positive, both of them above the x-axis, so it will speed up. So you can discover that in several ways. I wish this is clear, Shabab. Okay, there are exercises in the recitation questions. You can practice them. I have uploaded them already. We are done, Shabab. This is 3.7. This is all what we have for today. You can look at all the exam questions, what they are asking about, the total distance traveled. And this is polynomial, so easy. And this is not polynomial. It is a good question. Try to practice it. Speeding up, when it is speeding up. Also, this is a tan inverse, not polynomial, the total distance traveled. Asking here about what? When the object, the time, when is the object move slowing down? And so on, Shabab, practice these as much as possible to understand. The questions from this section should be very easy and very clear and should be on your, the grades of them should be in your, inside your pocket, because it is not difficult. The concept is clear. Let me now, Shabab, go to 3.9. There is no 3.8. 3.8 is about the exponential rate of growth and decay, so it will be included in the future, inshallah. Now for 3.8, we will skip 3.8, we will go to 3.9. 3.9 is also about the other applications of calculus. It is a kind of applied calculus about the related rates. It is very important section because it is about the applications. Most of you, they don't like mathematics because they feel What is the benefit of that? Why we are studying this? Now you will see why we are studying this and how it is related to the physical problem, geometrical problem, and even also mathematical problem. So of course, this section involves many ideas that is related to your previous knowledge of mathematics. There is nothing new here, no new rules, no new ideas, just we will apply what we have studied until now. But before that, Shabab, you need to recall some geometric formulas, please. You need to recall for the triangle, what is the area? A here, A is the area, C is the circumference, V is the volume. So you need to remember how to find the area of the triangle and of the circle, of the sector of a circle. And this is the circumference of the circle. Also for the 3D objects, what is the volume? The volume of the sphere here, the full volume of the cylinder, the volume of the cone. You should recall this. A here, it is the surface area when you have a 3D object. طبعاً, these are in the cover of your book, Shabab. I have put them for you here. So what are going to what we are going to have in this section, we will study the problems that contain two quantities related to each other by a specific relationship. And there is a rate of change, of course, included. Usually they will be with time. The change will be with time. It is the, what is the procedure here? What is the idea? The idea is to find the equation that relates the two quantities and then use the chain rule to differentiate them with respect to time. Let's take an example. We have here, Shabab, an example. What is important for this type of problems is to read it one time, two times, three times, until you understand it. If you didn't understand what is it about, you cannot solve it. And don't worry about the vocabulary. It is just specific, some specific words that you will get an idea about them when you solve several examples. Air is being pumped into a spherical balloon so that its volume increases at a rate of 100 centimeter cubed per second. How fast? How fast is the radius of the balloon increase when the diameter is 50 centimeter? It is important to ask yourself, what is the given information? What is given and what is unknown? What is required? What I have, what I want. What I have here? I have a spherical balloon. This is sphere, 3D object. He talked about the volume is increasing at a rate of 100. So we have a rate here. So the rate, when you have a rate, ya Shabab, wherever you have a rate, you have a derivative. This is a derivative. And it is clear that it is a ratio here. It is volume, because he mentioned the volume. Even if he didn't mention, it is clear here from the units. So what is given or what is unknown here, what is known is the rate of increase of the volume air is 100. So if V is the volume, let's say that V is the volume. What is this? This is dV. dV what?
dt.
dt. Because it is the rate of change, it is derivative. Because it is rate of change, it is derivative of something over with respect to something else. So we clearly talking about volume. So this is the derivative of the volume, the rate of change of the volume with respect to the time, because it will change with time. When you bump more air to the balloon, it will increase. So this is of course 100. Now, what is unknown? What is required? The rate of increasement, he asked about what? How fast is the radius of the balloon increasing? So he asking about how fast it is a rate. So it is a rate of increasement of the radius, the rate of increasing of the radius. When the diameter is 50, when the diameter is 50, this means that the radius is 25. Now, what is this? So what we want? We want the rate of what? Of the radius. So let's make the radius r. This means that we want dr dt, but not in general. We want dr dt at when r is what? When r is 25. So let V be the volume of the balloon and r is the radius. So these are the variables that I have here. And both of them are functions of time, Shabab. They will change with time. So this is what is given. This is what is unknown. What I want this now. This is my question. My dr dt with respect to time. when R is 25. So what I will do, I need to find, ya shabab, a relationship. What is the relationship between V and R in this case? This is the most important step, how to find the relationship between V and R.
The volume formula.
How to find it, ya shabab?
The volume formula.
The volume. He is talking about the volume. Volume of what?
Sphere.
Volume of sphere, because the balloon here is a sphere. So I need to go back here and ask myself, what is the volume of the sphere? The sphere, the sphere, the volume of the sphere is 4/3 r³. Here we are. This is the most important step. The relationship between the quantities that you have. Now, if you have it, halas, you are done. Now it is just, you will do what now? What is the next step, ya shabab?
Differentiate.
Differentiate using the chain rule. Now, keep in mind here that clearly here, clearly V is a function of what? Of R. Here it is. But R is a function of what? Another function. It is a function of what? Of time. It will change with time. So you remember that if you want to use the chain rule, it would be dy. If you want dv, you remember that if you have y as a function of x, of u, this is the chain rule that we studied. And u is a function of x. What will be dy dx? It will be dy dv du, then du dx. Similarly here, the dv dt, the derivative of v with respect to time, here it is, it will be dv dr dr dt. And it is not difficult to recognize, because this is just like you cancel this with this, look. It is dv dt dv dt. You don't need to do that, but it is important to know that it is there. So this is what is called the chain rule. Now you will differentiate this dv dt. You can differentiate directly. So it will be what, Ishabab? 4/3, this is a constant, times, what is the derivative of 3R? It is a
3R squared,
R prime, what is R prime here? It is not clear, you cannot write here R prime just like that. You should identify R prime here, what is it? It is dr dt, because you need to differentiate it to specify, you need to specify the variable that you are going to integrate or to differentiate with, sorry. To differentiate with. So it is important to use dr dt. Newton, don't use Newton notation, use Leibniz notation. So here we are, shabab. Now you can simplify just this three will be canceled with this three. And you have 4/r² dr dt. Now this is the derivative. You can skip this part, but it is there. You should realize that it is there. Now I have this, it is given. Now, this is, ya shabab, the relationship between the two rates of change. Now, I need to find the r dt. This is what I want. When what? When r is 25. Both r here equals to 25 and dv dt equals to 100. So solve it for the r dt. How to solve it for the r dt? Divide by this. Now, you have this, when dv dt is 100 and when r is 25, substitute, this will give you the rate of change of the radius. So this means that when the volume change by a rate of 100 centimeter, the rate of change of the radius will be 1/25, which is very slow, very, very, very small. It will increase slowly indeed. The rate of increasement is not that much. That's it. I have made it a little bit long because I have explained everything. I want you to understand the process, but I can summarize it here for you. Look at the summary of the solution. You can summarize it like this. You can solve it in 2 or 3 steps only. So you should write what is given, what is required, what is given, what is unknown. And this is also given, R is 25. You need this when R is 25. Now, the relationship, find the relationship between them, differentiate it, substitute. So it is like this, shabab. What is given? What is unknown? What is the relationship? Find the derivatives, substitute. Just like that. So I have listed here 7 steps for you when you have a problem that you want to solve. They are not with all the problems. The most complicated problem will have these 7 steps. But of course, in some problems, you can skip some of them. So first one, read the problem carefully. Draw a diagram if possible. In some problems, you need to sketch a graph or a diagram, not necessarily a graph. Introduce the notation. This is important, and you should be careful when you use the notation. You should assign symbols to all the quantities that they are functions of time. Recall that what is the function, what is the quantities that they change with time, and what is the quantities that is fixed, will not change with time. Express the given information and the required rate in terms of derivatives. You should rate or write any rate as derivative. Write an equation that relates the relationship. This is a very important step. What is the relationship between the quantities of the problem? If necessary, you can use the geometry of the situation to eliminate one of them. Usually, شباب, we prefer to have مثلاً y as a function of time. I cannot have it until now in this course, مثلاً as a variable of 2, t مثلاً and s. You should have it as one function of time only. So when you have 2 variables, try to eliminate one of them to make it one variable problem. You will study the two type or the 2 variables problem and more in math 201. Use the chain rule to differentiate, and this is clearly, and finally substitute the given information. There is a warning here, شباب. There is a common mistake that many students are doing. They do step number 7 before step number 6, and this is a mistake. So a common error is to substitute the given numerical information too early. Don't do that. First differentiate and then substitute. This should be done only after the differentiation. Step 7 follows step 6. Let's take another example here. Read it, ya shabab, carefully. You know that understanding the problem is the most important step. A ladder, we have a ladder here, 5 meters long, rest against a wall, a vertical wall. So let's say this is the ground and this is a wall. So against a vertical wall, if the bottom of the ladder, this is the bottom of the ladder, slides away from the base, from the rate, from the wall. So this means that it will go this direction. So after 1 minute, for example, it will become here. So it will slide away from the wall. So this is important, Shabab, too. Is it going to slide away or it will go closer to the wall? It slides away from the wall at a rate of 1 meter per second. So we have a derivative here because we have a rate. So let's call the distance from here to here, the distance from here to here, let's call it X. I think we mentioned this. Yes. Let X be the distance from the bottom of the ladder to the wall. So it is important to introduce your notation. Usually for the vertical, we will use Y. For the horizontal distances, we will use X. So what is this, Shabab? What will be this? This will be dx dt. Am I right? Because the distance between the bottom of the ladder and the wall will be 1 meter per second. The question is how fast is the top? This is the top of the ladder. How fast it means also a rate. We are talking about the rate of how fast it is. How fast is the top of the ladder sliding down? This is sliding down. But of course, after 1 second, it will become like this. So the distance, this distance will be smaller. So let's call it Y. Y is the distance from the top of the ladder to the ground. This is the ground. Now, sliding down. So this means that it is increasing, not increasing. When the bottom of the ladder is, when the bottom of the ladder is 3 meters from the wall. So this means what is required, what we want. We want dy dt, how fast is the top of the ladder. This is what we want, but not in general. We want it when what? When the bottom of the ladder is 3 meters from the wall. What is this, Shabab? This means when X is what? When X is 3. So if you can translate this word problem to mathematics to this way, you are done. And I did that for you. Remember, ya shabab, that X and Y here, usually we have Y as a function of X. Be careful here. Here, X and Y are both functions of time. You can use other letters if you are going to confuse. So here, X is a function of time and Y is a function of time. And this is the triangle. So this is the ladder and this is the ground, this is the wall. Now the question is, ya shabab, what is given? What is unknown? Who can tell me what is given? What is given is dx dt. What is unknown is dy dt when x is 3. So this is very important step to identify what is given, what is unknown. The most important step is the next one. Now, what is the relationship between these variables? Now my variables are x and y. What is the relationship between them, shabab? Who can tell me?
The circumference.
Sorry?
Circumference of a triangle.
No.
Pythagoras, x squared.
Pythagorean theorem, yes. You have a right triangle here, shabab. You remember the right triangle when you have, this is C, this is B, this is A. You know that C squared, it is A squared plus B squared, if this is a right triangle. So from the Pythagorean theorem, we have x squared plus y squared equals to what? To 25. And this is the most important step. If you have this relationship, you can continue now. Halas, you are done. Now differentiate both sides. Look, dx, 2x dx dt plus 2y dy dt. Notice that we differentiate here both of them with respect to the time. So we use that share rule for both of them. And the derivative of 25 is 0 with respect to any constant. It is a constant. Now this is given. I have this. Now I need to do dy dt. This is what I want, but not I want it in general. So you can simplify. Solve this one for this, because this is what I want. Solve it for dy dt. Move this to the another side. Divide by 2y. This is what you are going to have. Is it clear how we obtain that? It should be clear. Now this is dy dt equals to negative x over y dx dt. This is the in general. What we want to evaluate it at x equals 3. So we want this at x equals 3. Now if this is given for me, it is 1. Now x is 3. This will be equals to at x equals 3. It will be equals to what? Negative 3, and this one is 1 over what, ya shabab? I need to, why? Why I, oh. Where, from where I can find why? From here. Y x squared plus y squared equals to 25. This means that y squared equals to 25 minus x squared, which is 9. It will be 16. So y will be what? Y will be 4. It should be positive, ya shabab, because we are talking about distance here. So y is 4. Done. And you can see clearly, shabab, that dy dt will be negative 3 over 4. This is, by the way, meter, not it is a mistake. It is meter per second. Now, what do you think, ya shabab? Why it is negative? Why the rate of change here is negative? While here it was positive, look.
It's decreasing.
Yes, because it is what?
Decreasing.
Yes. Look, the distance here, the vertical distance will be less and less with time. After a long time, the ladder will be like this. It is keeping sliding down. So this distance here will be increasing and this one will be increasing. So when the rate of change is increasing, it will be positive. When the rate of change is negative, it means it will decrease. On time, we have finished example 2. Inshallah, next time we will continue from example 3. This is all what we have for today, shabab. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions, I have like 1 or 2 minutes for you before going to the another class. Any question, Shabab? Okay, thank you very much, Shabab, and see you, inshallah, next class.
Doctor?
Yes, please.
I just had a problem in the middle.